In terms of Stanley Cup champions, this one's remarkable. The 2004 Tampa Bay Lightning weren't spectacular. And I don't say that as a slight to Tampa fans. I don't say it as anything more than they got hot at the right time and they were hot for quite a while. So, Tampa had 106 points that year. They were second in the league. They were deadly in the playoffs. Maybe a bit lucky in Game 7 against Calgary. And Calgary fans will always talk about that goal, the same as Canuck fans will talk about certain plays. And any fan of any team will talk about a certain goal or a certain play that changed history. Calgary will look at this as the Stanley Cup that got away. For me, it is the Stanley Cup that Tampa Bay got that was their sole Stanley Cup. So, 2004, Tampa Bay Lightning. I did the entire roster, and there's a reason why, and I'll get to that. Dave Andrechuk, Freddie Modine, Vinny LeCavalier, Marty St. Louis, Brad Richards, Nikolai Habibulin, Pavel Kabina, Dan Boyle, Ruslan Fedotenko, Daryl Sador, Corey Sarich, Tim Taylor, Corey Stillman, a lot of Coreys, well, a couple Coreys, Jason Cullimore, John Graham, Chris Dingman, Nolan Pratt, Brad Lukowich, Andre Roy, Dmitry Afanasenkov, Martin Seabach, Ben Clymer, Darren Rumble, Stan Nets-Cash, Eric Perrin. All have their name on the Stanley Cup. Not a lot of Hall of Famers in there. And really not a lot of guys. I mean, there's going to be some debate. Like, obviously, St. Louis is a Hall of Famer. Andrechuk is finally a Hall of Famer. It's likely LeCavalier becomes a Hall of Famer. It's 50-50 for me that Brad Richards does. But if they do, they go in together. So, this is a bittersweet moment. Because all of the signs are here for Tampa to win another one. Regular season, Marty St. Louis leads the way with 94 points. In the playoffs, Brad Richards leads the way with 26. He wins the Conn Smythe with those 26 points. Nikolai Habibulin, a 1.71 goals against and a .933 save percentage. Again, there's people who are going to say certain teams won without good goaltending. I argue every team has to have good goaltending. Doesn't have to be great, but you have to have good goaltending. Your goaltending can't be costing you games or you're out pretty quick. So, some interesting stats here. In 23 playoff games, Richards with 26 points, St. Louis with 24, Modine with 19, LeCavalier with 16, Fedotenko with 14, 12 of them are goals. Andrechuk gets 14, 13 assists, and he holds up a Stanley Cup to end his career. And it was a really nice moment, you know, and it's those nice moments that get you through. I'm going to let Calgary fans in on a bit of a secret. I was cheering for Tampa in the final. This was one of those few finals where the team that won was the team that I was pulling for. I didn't like how it happened. If that makes you feel any better at all, I didn't like how it happened. I was not a fan of how it happened, but they won it. It didn't look like they would after Game 5. Calgary was up 3-2, and it looked like they were going to take it home, and then they didn't. And I know Calgary fans are going to be in the comment section talking about how they got robbed, and I don't blame them. Again, I would say the same thing. But this was a good, very good team that played exceedingly well together, and for whatever reason, coming out of the lockout, it fell apart quickly. This team was the first team since, I think, 1918. I want to say 1918 was when the flu canceled the Stanley Cup. First team to not have to worry about losing their Stanley Cup champion status the year after. They were still Stanley Cup champs in 2005. Not a repeat, just nobody dethroned them because there was no hockey played. And it was a bittersweet moment for that reason. The Detroit Red Wings had a payroll of $80 million. Couldn't get out of the second round. And the Calgary Flames, who were not one of the highest paid teams in the league, get to the Stanley Cup Finals and push Tampa to Game 7. Tampa was one of the higher paid teams, not as highly paid as Detroit. The Rangers were paying money hand over fist, and this was the final we got. They beat the Islanders in five. Montreal, they swept. And I remember that, and I was happy. They beat Philadelphia in seven, which was a brutal series. And then they beat Calgary in seven. And again, it's one of those things where you look at it, and if Philly wins that game seven, does Philly win a Stanley Cup? And am I wearing a Flyers jersey and a Flyers hat? Maybe. Does Calgary beat Philly? Maybe. That's the wonders of guesses and deciding who may or may not have won what, whenever. The nice thing with Tampa was this was not a trap team. Yes, those are trap numbers for Nikolai Habibulin. But this was not a trap team. This was a team that could score. This was a team that did score. And them against Calgary in the finals was a very, very entertaining Stanley Cup final. It was probably the most entertaining Stanley Cup final since 94. I would say since 94. And it's funny because coming out of the lockout, we would see these rule changes in order to open up a game which already had a very good Stanley Cup final before the lockout. And again, it's a shame because this team could have won in 2005. Calgary could have won in 2005. Everybody could have won in 2005. So, Fedotenko's 12 goals stick out. Andrechuk's 13 assists stick out because he only had one goal in the playoffs. And Andrechuk is known as a goal scorer. 600 goals is why he's in the Hall of Fame. And yet in the playoffs, he falls in line, and he's the one passing the puck, and Fedotenko's the one putting it away. You would have made real money in Vegas betting on those totals. That Andrechuk was going to be a pure passer in the playoffs and Fedotenko was going to be the sniper. Yeah, you would have made good money. Le Cavalier was good. Modine was fantastic. Freddie Modine, after a 57-point regular season and a 19-point playoffs, he was expected to be more than what he was. And it is one of those things where I talk about a guy having a career year. Modine was a beast for Tampa that year. And the rest of his career, he would be trying to get back to that. That's how career years work. You don't get back to it right away if you get back to it at all. And again, it's interesting in that when I was doing the Edmonton ones and the Islander ones, we had all these Hall of Famers. And people say, well, in the post-cap world, you can't put that team together. Right. This was pre-cap. This was when the disparity between the highest paid and the lowest paid teams was the greatest. And the Calgary Flames made the finals. And Tampa won the Stanley Cup with virtually no Hall of Famers compared to the teams from the 80s. I would argue that because of expansion, adding a lot of teams, we no longer had a situation where you could have six or seven Hall of Famers on one team. Regardless of your payroll. And if you did have six or seven Hall of Famers, odds are you're overpaying them and you're not going anywhere. Those Hall of Famers are likely over the hill. Because you're not going to draft six or seven Hall of Famers unless you're Detroit. And even then, for Detroit's Hall of Famers, either they had guys they brought in, like Brett Hull, Dominic Hasek, or there'd be guys like Zetterberg and Datsyuk coming in while other guys were going out. So for me, if I had to grade this team, I would say they're below a lot of the 80s teams. I'd even say they're below a number of the 90s teams. But in a seven-game series with this team, with the scoring depth they had, and the almost inhumanly good defense that they had in those playoffs. And think about it. This was a defense that had Dan Boyle, Pavel Kabina, Corey Sarich, Jason Cullimore. This was not a who's who of defense in terms of actually playing in your own zone and playing well. And yet in these playoffs, everything came together. This is one of those times where I can say a team won a Stanley Cup without a huge impactful number one defenseman. Boyle was really good, but no defenseman was in their top six scorers, and their number six scorer had 39 points. This was defense by committee, goaltending by Nikolai Habibulin when he was the Great Wall, and offense, again, mostly by committee, but Brad Richards was in the zone. And Brad Richards, again, this was as good as he got in the postseason. He had some very good regular seasons that were better than the 79-point season here. Remember the 91-point season in Dallas as an example. But, man, in those playoffs, he was virtually unstoppable. He was every measure of that Conn Smythe. And this is why when CBC had its let's grade the Stanley Cup champions, I didn't partake, and I thought it was a joke. Because you're grading teams that won a championship against each other. And, yeah, maybe this team gets swept by the 1984 Oilers. Maybe they beat them. Maybe with the defense by committee and Habib Bulin standing on his head and Grant Fuhr at the other end of the ice, maybe the Oilers get beat. Maybe Tampa just finds out that Grant Fuhr isn't that great a goalie and they just start scoring five a game on him. Meanwhile, Habib Bulin standing on his head and putting up that 1.71 goals against Edmonton. That's why I didn't vote in that crap. That's why, as much fun as it is to talk about great champions, this team proves that that's kind of a fool's errand. Speaking of fool's errands, tomorrow, I'm going to get into the 2005 Stanley Cup that never was. Who could have made it, might have made it, and who could have won it. And that's going to be fun. But that's for tomorrow. This was the 2004 Tampa Bay Lightning, Dave Andrechuk's swan song, and he went out a victor, and Calgary's bitter pill that to this day I know still hurts. So you have my condolences, Calgary, on this one. Maybe soon Calgary will hold up a Stanley Cup again. I'd like to see some Stanley Cups in Canada. Yeah, doing this series as it is, it is kind of sad to watch as Canada has not been mentioned in a week and a half. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. Don't forget to hit like and subscribe if you're browsing your way through. Thank you so much for watching. I'll talk to you again soon.